So when we discussed classes and objects, we looked at this example of this point. So let's see how it works here. So here is the basic definition of point with the xy coordinates, right? So we have a class point, and this has this initialization where it takes the values a and b as the initial coordinates of the point. And then we have this function translate, which shifts x by delta x and y by delta y. And we have this function odistance, which computes the Euclidean distance, as is called by Pythagoras formula, x squared plus y squared whole square root, right? So now I can create these points by using this. Nothing has run, so I must first run the code there. So I run the code to create the point class, and now I run this, and now it has created two points for me called P and Q at 3, 4 and 7, 10. Now at this point, if I try to print out something like P plus Q, then it's going to say that there is no, remember we said that you have these add functions and string functions. So even if I just try to print P, for instance, right, if I just try to print P, I will get some kind of useless output which says that this is a point object, right? It doesn't tell me the coordinates or anything, it just tells me that this is a point object. This is the same thing happens if you try to print, for example, a list or a dictionary sometimes without, you know, getting the values out properly. So for instance, if you try to print range of something which is not a list, it will just say this is a range function, okay? So that's the kind of useless output. But on the other hand, I can compute the distance. So now P is 3, 4. So if you remember your Pythagoras theorem, then 3, 4, 5 is a right angle triangle. So the distance of this point 3, 4 is 5 from the thing. So if I compute the distance of P from the origin, it is 5. And if I compute the distance of Q from the origin, okay, so this is, notice that this kind of gives you this helpful hint as to what function to complete it, but let us not worry about that. So in a Python notebook, I can do this kind of thing. I can implicitly call two things and it will give me a pair. So it says that P is at distance 5, Q is at distance 12.2, because that is 7 squared plus 10 squared, which is 184 square root, which is something like 12.2, okay? Sorry, 149 square root, which is something like, okay. Now, if I ask what is P dot R, then it will say that this is not defined because there is no internal value called R. Okay, then the next thing we did was we defined this R theta form. So now I have a new definition of point in which I use this R theta form. So remember that we convert xy to R by using the distance formula, and we use this tan inverse to construct the angle and so on, right? So now if I take this definition and run it, remember in a Jupyter notebook, the last thing that ran works. So this is now my new definition of point. Okay, so now if I take this and if I again execute this, I get two new points, P and Q, but these are now defined in terms of R and theta, right? So again, if I try to print P, I will still get some meaningless thing. If I try to compute the distance, okay, I get the same distance, but this time it's coming from R. It's not coming from a calculation involving P dot X and P dot Y. And I can check that I'm using the new format by asking now what is P dot R, and it tells me P dot R is 5.0, right? So similarly, I can ask what is P dot theta, right? So it tells me that there's a mistake here. This should be self. Also be self. See, this is what happens in Python. If you forget the self in an object, then it doesn't. So it takes theta as an arbitrary value. So everywhere this should be self. Okay, so let me run this again. Okay, so now I've updated it. So I had self dot r and self dot theta, which I had forgotten the self part of it. So now let me create these points again, right? And I can print the point. So notice theta was not being used for the distance. That's why O distance worked, right? Because I was just looking up R and getting it. But now if I say what is PR and P dot theta, I get that P dot R is 5 and P dot theta is 0.972. But remember that this is not in degrees, but in radians, okay? So just remember the unit. So that is the two different formats. Now we also said that you could have these special functions string and add to convert. So let's compile these things, right? So notice that this thing which was obscured in the slide, right? So this is how we convert to a string. I take self.x, self.y, convert each of them to a string and then embed it inside this open bracket, comma and close bracket. So I create a new string which has an open bracket, the string version of self.x, comma, the string version of self.y, close bracket, right? So this is my output string that I create, and this is what str does. And add, if you remember, takes self.x, a new point p, p.x, adds them up and then creates a new point, right? So now let me replace, this is my third definition of point. It's the, I've gone back to the x comma y definition, but I've added this self dot str and self dot add. So now let me go back up. So this is again the advantage of Jupyter Notebook. I don't have to type anything again. I can go back and re-execute, right? So now I re-execute this code. So again, now it's created two points, but this is a new definition. And as proof that it's a new definition, I can now say, tell me what is the value of p plus q, right? Now this has two things. One is p plus q has to be executed. It has to give me a point. What is that point? It should have 3 plus 7 as the x coordinate, 10, 4 plus 10, 14 as the y coordinate, right? And it should then separately, because print should convert it to a string, it should not give me this kind of strange output which says it is a point at so and so hexadecimal, right? It should give me the values. So if I execute this, indeed I get the output 10, 14. So two things have happened. It has added and it has converted to a string, okay? So this is just to illustrate how this class and object definition work. And again, an illustration about how in this notebook format, you can keep updating the code very naturally and keep rerunning the code without typing a lot of stuff back and forth. So it's very convenient for this kind of incremental creation of code.